And the other application, I think, is we also see that I come to customers and they ask me to build models, predictive models, for example, on data. But I'm not allowed to see the data. I'm not allowed to use the data because it's because of privacy regulations. I'm not allowed to use it. So in that case, we could say, well, can you transfer that data from original data into synthetic data? And that's exactly what we did together with Cinto. And I wanted to test it because it's very interesting. But when I build predictive models, is the predictive power the same? Is the information in the data set, is it preserved, yes or no?
Okay,
And that was finally the
and
test.
you had the chance, right, to work with synthetic data to investigate the results of analytical models on synthetic data. Now, I'm curious, tell me more. What are your findings?
Yeah, we can have a look at the findings. Do you want to talk about the output of what you delivered to me as first before I show the output?
Yeah, I think that's definitely interesting. So basically, this is a question that we receive frequently. So what we typically do is for every synthetic data set that we generate is deliver a data quality report. And that includes various statistics like distributions, correlations, and multivariate distributions to really indicate the data quality where we compare the original data with the synthetic data. So I think it will be interesting to go through that and then, of course, dive into the complex analytics. So I think what we see here is the distributions. So we see it in gray, you see the original data, and in blue, you see the synthetic data. And we can actually go to the next slide to zoom in on two of these graphs. So on the left side, you see one categorical value, in this case, the churn. And there you really see that when we compare the original data with the synthetic data, that the results are really similar. So the same amount of persons in the data set that churned and didn't churn. And then to the second illustration, there we see the age. And there we also see that the lines really overlap when we compare the original data with the synthetic data. Then when we go to the correlations, we have a correlation matrix where we compare on the left side the original data and on the right side the synthetic data. Normally, a correlation is between -1 and +1, but for illustrative purposes, we indicated it with color intensity to really compare the patterns. And also here we see similar results. And then to the final part of our quality report, the multivariate distributions. There we combine the combination of variables and the frequency of those combinations in the data set. And even there we see similar results. So for example, on the right side, you see the combination of clients that churn in a certain segment. Even there we see that the patterns are similar. And this is basically the highlight of our data quality report. But that's of course from our side. And I think the interesting part is, of course, okay, what if we do advanced analytics on that data? And that's of course the case that we did with this use case.
So the input data is similar to the original
Yeah,
data.
it's very, very similar. It's not exactly the same, it's
It's
similar, it's not
similar,
the same.
yeah. But we would assume then that the results on the original data and the synthetic data are also similar.
Comparable, yeah.
Is that true, Edwin?
Yes and no. We will see. So I used this diagram to show you what we actually did. So I sent an original data set to Cinto and they synthesized this data set. But the question was also, well, let's compare it also to anonymization because we already talked about anonymization. We said, well, you lose a lot of information in that anonymization data set. Well, is it really true? So what we did, I had this data set from a telecommunications industry, 56,000 people having left the company. So there's churn, it's a churn case. That's the target for my modeling. A lot of inputs, 128 inputs, potential features for the models. So I really, it was a great data set to build some analytical models. And we gave it to Cinto and they, of course, synthesized the data set, but also we tried some anonymization techniques. And then when I received both data sets, I started modeling using Sesfaya. So I built a churn model on the original data set and actually a couple of models. I used classical regression techniques, classical decision trees, but also more sophisticated techniques, neural networks, gradient boosting, random forest, these kind of techniques. And I used the standard options of SAS, because I didn't want to tweak the model too much because then you don't really can compare it. So the standard options of Sesfaya, just use Sphere, build some models, and look at the results. And the results were very, very promising, not for anonymization, but for synthetic data. When you use it for, you look at the results for anonymization, we look at, and for the non-machine learning experts in the audience, we look at the area under the curve. And the curve, that is the ROC curve, and that's, well, telling you something about what are the true positives and the true negatives in your data. Is it, is the accuracy of the model okay? And when you compare it in the original data with the anonymized data, we see that on the original data, the area under the curve is 0.8. And on anonymized data, it's 0.6. And the maximum would be 1. An optimal model would have 1. So 0.8 is rather good. But 0.6, well, a random model should only be already have a half, 0.5. So we can't really use that anonymized model because you lose a lot of information, a lot of predictive power. But then the question is, what about synthetic data? So the next step, we did the same. We sent the data to CentOAI. We have the synthetic data set. We built some models, the same algorithms, the regression models, neural networks, gradient boosting, etc. And now, of course, on the original data set, still we have the 0.8 area under the curve. But also on the synthetic data, now we have 0.8 under the curve. So it's very similar. Not exactly the same. In fact, it was a little bit better. But that's more or less the variability. Yeah? So the data is not exactly the same, but a little different. So it's very promising. We're very happy about this. But you would argue that, well, is it really a good test? Because, well, this is actually the test set. Eh? What I used the test set of both the original data and the synthesized data. So actually, I want to use that model on the original data. Mm. So next set, finally, I used a holdout data set.
Okay.
So there was 10% of the data I didn't send to Cinto. So I used that holdout data set to test the model on synthetic data on that original 10% original data. And then also in this case, the predictive power was preserved. We could have the same accuracy on this holdout data set. So it's really promising.
Yeah, so they can underestimate you, Edwin. You always have something in the back.
Yeah,
now,
yeah.
When I see those results, am I right to state that we don't have to worry anymore about the accuracy of our predictions when we use synthetic data?
Yes, well, I'm an analytical guy, so I never worry about analytics, of course.
But, of course.
Okay. Yes, the answer to this great question, the answer is a little bit yes and no. And maybe it's good to explain with the next picture. We saw the accuracy of the models on synthetic data is similar, almost the same as on original data. It's for random forest, for regression models. In this case, for a decision tree, it was not the case because the data was too complex to create a nice decision tree. But for the other models, the more complex models, it's really the same. So indeed, we don't have to worry about the accuracy of the models on synthetic data.